If you stumbled upon this video, I'm guessing you're still confused between sensitivity and specificity. These are the two terms which are used commonly in AUC-ROC curves. So we'll be covering that in detail in this video. If you really like the content of the videos, please consider clicking the subscribe button. That is what motivates me to create more videos. So let's start with the actual content now. So what exactly is sensitivity? The simplest answer to sensitivity is positive recall. As we all know, positive recall is out of all the positive samples in my labeled data set, how much is my classifier able to pick up? Let's look at the formula of sensitivity. Sensitivity is the ratio of true positive upon true positive plus false negative. Let's calculate the sensitivity for this confusion matrix where my rows are predictions and columns are actual values. And the values of my confusion matrix are 50, 10, 5 and 200. So in our case, the true positive is 50, true negative is 200, false positive is 10 and false negative is 5. Going by the formula of positive recall, which is true positive by true positive plus false negative, we have sensitivity equal to 0.90. Let's do the same exercise for specificity, which is negative recall. Now, negative recall is out of all the negative samples that I have in my data set, how much is my classifier able to pick up or correctly classify into negative? Let's now look at the formula of negative recall, which is the ratio of true negative by true negative plus false positive. Based on the formula, let's calculate specificity for our given confusion matrix, which is nothing else but the ratio of true negative by true negative plus false positive. So in our case, true negative is 200, false positive is 10. So we have a ratio of 200 by 210, which approximates to 0.95. This was my attempt at explaining sensitivity and specificity. I hope you all liked it. If you do have any questions with what we've covered in this video, then feel free to ask in the comment section below and I'll do my best to answer those. If you enjoy these tutorials and would like to support them, then the easiest way is to simply like the video and give it a thumbs up. And also it's a huge help to share these videos with anyone whom you think would find them useful. Please consider clicking the subscribe button to be notified for future videos, and thank you so much for watching.